That, we've all heard that debt is bad, but realistically, just about everybody has some debt. Not many people can really afford to pay cash for a home or for a car.
And knowing the difference between the good debt and the bad debt is key to your financial success. Annie Mattingly with Forum Credit Union is here this afternoon to give us insight on which one is which, what makes one that. So what are the factors for getting a good loan and making it a smart financial decision?
Well, the first factor to look at is why are you getting the loan? So if it's for a house or a car or something like that, that could be a good reason.
So somebody would say, why is that good?
Well, because you're building a long-term asset. A house is going to have value, or a home improvement, you're going to add value to your house. A car may help you get to work so you can earn money. So they're value-added debts.
And things you need as well.
Yes.
What else would make a good reason for getting yourself in some debt?
Well, perhaps you have a savings account and you could pay for everything, but let's say you're earning 8%, and I know that's not really happening right now, but let's say that you are and you can get a loan for 5 or 6%. You'd be better off getting the loan because you're still making 2% on that savings amount.
What are other good reasons for people to borrow?
Another one could be to pay for college education. You know, maybe you didn't save enough, so student loans, parent loans, or a home equity loan to pay for that. Don't use your retirement funds to pay for your children's education.
All right, let's look at the bad. We went over the
good. Okay.
What are the bad reasons for getting debt?
Well, it's if you're using it for debt for short-term purposes. Mm-hmm. Two of the biggest are vacations and holiday shopping.
People do it with the holiday shopping.
I don't like that video. I don't want it to seem like golf is bad here. Why can these be harmful? Is it because they're just short-term?
Yeah, because they're short-term enjoyment. And what happens is a lot of people will take 2 or 3 years to pay for those. So you've had the vacation and you're still paying for it. And the other thing is, especially holiday shopping, if you're using a credit card, you tend to overspend.
Okay, what about those credit cards? Just wondering.
Okay.
Sometimes, 18 months, no interest, and someone can maybe pay that off. What would you say to those people? Is that okay?
I'd say that's okay if you have the money to pay it off, because then it's that whole idea of, well, I've got my savings, so I'm gonna earn money on it. When 18 months comes up, I'm gonna pay it off and no interest, as long as you're disciplined to pay it off when it comes there.
And things can really get out of control, and that's when it's too late, right?
Yes.
How do they spiral?
Well, one of the biggest is you start using your credit card to fund, you buy the concert tickets because you didn't have enough cash. And then you take your whole weekend entertainment and you start putting it on your credit card. And then you start living beyond your means. That's kind of a really bad debt.
You mentioned home improvements.
Yes.
Appliances, do they apply as home improvements? Like, could you?
Certainly those do.
Just wondering.
Certainly those do.
Just wondering. Maybe a little personal there.
You're going to be saving the clips from this show, creating a little file. Where can people find you, Andy?
At forumcu.com.
All right, before we get to weather, one more look outside.